Well, keeping your home warm and cozy during the winter months does not have to break the bank.
Yeah, in fact, the Tennessee Valley Authority wants to help make sure you lower your energy bills this season. Jim Purcell is in with the energy expert with the TVA, and he joins us this morning with some energy and money-saving tips that you can do right in your own home.
Jim,
welcome
to
Live at Noon.
Thank you. Good morning.
How have we been kind of facing off for the past few months? Have energy levels leveled off? Have they been higher than usual because of the winter, or what?
Probably higher for September because we had such a hot month. So we can expect higher bills coming in October just due to the air conditioning costs, which is a big portion of your bill, usually about half.
Okay, so for right now, for the next month, maybe we can just keep the energy off. But we do know come the end of November, December, we're going to get some cold temperatures.
Absolutely.
So what can we do to keep those bills low?
Well, first and foremost is the thermostat setting.
Okay.
As I mentioned before, heating is about 50% of your energy bill. So every degree above 68 degrees is 3% more on your bill.
Wow.
So if you're keeping your house 75, you're making a choice to spend more on your energy bill, kind of like your grocery bill.
Right.
It's the choice to either buy ground beef or steak. Ground beef is 68 degrees. 75 degrees would be steak.
So, Jim, you're saying it actually can make a difference, because a lot of us will wonder, well, what other means do we need to take to either stay warm or stay cool, depending on the season, of course. What do we need to do there, or at least consider doing?
Well, in the winter, for sure, clothes.
Okay.
You know, that's easier to do in the winter. We can add extra clothes. In the summer, circulating the air around you, 78 may feel or seem warm to you. But if you use a ceiling fan, which uses very little energy, or a floor fan, you can keep that thermostat higher. And again, in the winter, add extra clothes. Don't use space heaters. They're not very efficient. So using your central heating and air system and leaving all the vents open, all the doors open, and making sure you change your filters every month. Those are really important.
Does the ceiling fan, since heat rises, does the ceiling fan help keep the heat down where we are as well in the winter, or should we turn our ceiling fans off in the winter?
I would suggest turning them off in the winter unless you have a really high ceiling and reverse it, because you don't want that cool air blowing on you in the winter, because it makes you feel cooler and you could turn your thermostat up and increase your bill.
Okay.
So be very careful with ceiling
fans.
That
makes a lot of sense right there. Jim, you got a huge display over here. I know a lot of folks are kind of concerned about which light bulbs to actually use these days, and what can they actually do. What are we looking at there?
Okay, this is a really good visual comparison. This is an older incandescent type bulb.
Okay.
And you can see the brightness there. It's about 600 lumens.
Okay.
The power usage there is about 50 watts.
Okay.
Is that good, bad, or what?
Well, that's to me bad compared to what we could be doing.
Okay, but we like the bright lights.
Yes,
we like
do.
The bright
lights.
That's
the problem with these babies here for a lot of folks.
Yes, and these are going out now. And the point of having those up here is you just mentioned that when I turn those on, it takes a little bit longer for the light to get brighter.
Okay.
Plus, they're expensive at the beginning. Now, that's okay because they last a long time, but if you break one, you're really not happy.
And speaking of that, these compact fluorescents, if you break them, they have mercury in them.
Oh.
So we don't want to throw those away in a trash can.
Okay.
And we really are getting away from those and going more toward the LED.
Okay, I've seen those.
Right.
In fact, I've bought those on the end. How does that save us?
Well, an LED, notice here that we're only using 8 watts.
Oh, wow.
Compared to the 50. And I think you can see that the light output is at least the same. I can actually turn on these two LED bulbs. I've got twice the light output for 16 watts compared to 50.
Wow, that's a huge difference.
That is.
Absolutely.
And cost-wise on the front end, are they about the same?
These are probably, if you buy them in quantity, $1 to $1.50 each, and it's better to buy quite a few. And as you replace your bulbs, replace these now with an LED.
Okay.
These you would probably wait till they go out
because
their usage is about the same.
All right, Jay, we've got about a minute left here, if not less. What about duct ceiling comparison right there, the other display?
The duct ceiling comparison, the reason I have that here is that I mentioned before half of your bill is heating and cooling. Your duct system is out of sight, out of mind. Most people do not even see it. It's in the ceiling or underneath the floor.
Right.
And many times they're not properly sealed. So this one does not have the tape or sealing on the joints where it comes out here on the side. So it's like having 10 ones in your pocket and you pay one and lose the others.
You should seal
it. You're losing air.
Right, you're losing air. So a good low-cost tip is to have the seal by a professional with a product called Mastic or UL-181 approved duct tape.
Covered it. Okay. And very quickly, what about like home computers, things like that? Should you leave them plugged in or?
This display is not coming on at the moment, obviously. Let me check the battery.
We're trying to save some money here.
Yeah, and we surely are. There it goes.
Or maybe we didn't pay the bill.
Well, it's trying.
Okay. So leaving a computer on, which is something that a lot of people do.
Well, the advice here is this shows you which one uses the most energy, and a computer uses less than a television. A light uses the least amount.
Okay.
Heating and air the most, water heating second. So computers, turn them off.
Gotcha.
Televisions, turn them off. It's more important to turn your television off when you leave the room than a light bulb.
All right, that makes a lot of sense.
I would not have known that.
Jim, thank you very much for being here.
You're welcome.
Very good information. We do appreciate it.
Appreciate you saving us.
Thanks for having us.